Hey man, I'm so glad in myself. Hey man, so y'all help me with this. I get joy when I think about
what you done for me.
I get joy when I think about
what you done for me.
What you done for me one day.
Joy you gave us today. We have to thank you again, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the wonderful pastor and wife. We thank you, Lord, for the 25 long years that they have tolerated in this business. We want to thank the Lord for it in Jesus' name. And oh God, look on them today. Touch every heart in here today. Uplift them, Lord. Give them joy, peace, and happiness. Let them enjoy the service today. Let them feel good down in the soul. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Come in today, Lord. Stir them up, Lord. Let the Spirit work on them today. Let them feel the power of God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We thank you right now, Lord. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your wonderful gifts. We thank you, Lord, for you being in the presence of us today. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, call on him, Lord. Let the Lord be in your power. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Come on in right now, Lord. We are waiting on you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Rise, my Lord. In the name of Jesus. Give us joy, Lord. Joy, Lord. Down in our hearts. In the name of Jesus. Somebody needs you for one day. Somebody needs you for another.
They who labor in the word and in doctrine. May God have blessings for the reading and the hearers of this holy word.
Amen. Amen. None other than Superintendent Michael R. Jordan Sr. and Missionary Rachel Jordan. Just loosen up. Amen. And let's prepare to praise the Lord on today. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. We thank Superintendent Jordan and First Lady Jordan for their years of service. Let's celebrate them on today. Amen. He's looking sharper than a tack over there. Sharper than a twin sword. Thank you, Pastor Collin. Sharper than a two-inch sword. And First Lady Jordan looking cleaner than the Board of Health over there. Amen. They looking good over there. Look like they headed to a banquet somewhere or something. You cool in the field. Amen. We thank the Lord for everyone who's here, all of our pastors. Let's say amen for Pastors Collins. Amen. He's going to bring us out on the today on the word. Amen. Amen. All of the ministers. Amen. Amen. Pastor Gilbert, right? Amen. And First Lady, let's say amen. Amen. We thank the Lord and to everybody who's there. Do me a favor today and take your right hand, place it over your left shoulder,
Now just pat yourself on the back. All right, all right. Everybody been recognized now. Amen. Let's receive our praise and worship team as they take us onto the throne. Amen.
Oh, what a mighty God we serve. Hey, what a mighty God we serve. Thank you.
doubts tonight. Can't nobody do that like Jesus. I love me some Sister Henry. Thank the Lord I met her when I did. But she can't do me like Jesus. I believe that alone. Nobody. I don't care what your name is. Nobody can do me like Jesus. Why? Because he's my friend. Amen. Amen. We're moving on in our service on today. We have a power pack program on today. Amen. And we're going to get Sister Henry. She's supposed to be coming and being our mistress of ceremony today. Amen. Let's say amen for Missionary Henry as she comes.
So think in your heart to give a response, amen. Yeah. So while she's up talking, if you want to give a response, be ready, amen. First, give an honor to God to the ministers on the roster. Are y'all ready to have a praise party? I said, are y'all ready to have a praise party? You guys, this ain't no ordinary Sunday. We come together to celebrate 25 years of Pastor Superintendent Michael Jordan and his first and our first lady, Rachel Jordan. So tonight is not no ordinary celebration. So we want you to relax. We want you to get into the spirit. And we want you to help us celebrate our pastor and our first lady. So it don't matter if you've been here 25 years, 25 months, 25 weeks, or 25 minutes. You are welcome to the party.
Amen.
25 minutes that you've been here, you are part of the party. Amen. At this time, there's a response from a visitor. Don't all jump at once. Just need one. Don't need five. Just need one to come and respond to the welcome. That was so beautiful, given. Come on, first thing.
Honor to God and everybody, Pastor Dillon, thank you for being here. Pastor Dillon, to Reverend Jordan and Sister Jordan, look real beautiful there. Praise the Lord. You've been here 25 years. That's a great big blessing. Let's give God a hand clap. Reverend Jordan and Sister Jordan, a hand clap. Congrats on the year. Hope y'all have a good year. And God bless you. You look good. Happy anniversary.
Amen. We're going to worship from our Behind the Religious Choir. Amen. Let's sing as the choir gathers into the cool Pentecostal as the Behind the Mission District Choir this time. But come on, choir members. We're going to stand to the choir stand. Amen. We just thank the Lord for a beautiful service. Amen. Y'all excited on today? Everybody feeling good in their body? Y'all should be after that praise and worship. Y'all should be ready to, y'all ready to run. Amen. We're going to receive the choir at this time for an eighth selection. Let's say amen as they come.
Amen. Amen. Can we bless the Lord one time this evening? I say, can we bless the Lord one time this evening? Amen. This is a real simple song. It just says, Lord, you've been so good. And if you don't really have anything, if you can't really think of anything to be thankful to God, just think about this. 25 years. God kept you up every day for 25 years. So if you go to 165, now you're 25. Now you're up to 125.
Yeah.
God to the pastor, first lady. You understand the poor thing? It's the blessing and the deed and honor and the privilege to stand up here and talk about my beautiful mother.
Good evening, everyone. I'd like to first give honor to God, our Savior. And first of all, Superintendent Michael Jordan, First Lady, Miss Rachel Jordan. I'm not going to be up here long. First, I'd just like to say, I thank y'all for what y'all do. And I know everybody in Holy Temple already know that. Coming from my mouth, I just like to say, I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. Thank y'all for inviting me to y'all family. And Mary, your beautiful daughter. Right. I can't say enough about Mr. Jordan. I mean, he's like my father. I told him before, I'm glad, not saying it the wrong way, I'm not the son because I couldn't marry Miss Rita. So, my mother-in-law, they great, they always there for me. I'm in the hospital, accident, they're always there. So I know y'all know that, but coming from my heart, I love y'all and I hope y'all always there for me, my family, and I appreciate that.
A woman of dignity, a woman of giving, a woman of compassion, a woman of love, a woman of class. As you can see, she keep my daddy up to speed too as well. She is a woman who influences with her voice. As y'all know, she got that strong and powerful voice that can influence people. And sometimes my daddy say, Rachel, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. But that is a gift from the Lord. God has equipped her from the beginning. Her father was a pastor. Her mother was a first lady. She grew up watching her parents. How things should be and go in the grand old church of God in Christ. She watched her mother walk in the shoes of a first lady. She grew up singing with her sisters. They were called the war singers. So as you can see, God had a plan for her. Sometimes I ask my mama, Mama, how do you do it? How do you do it? And her exact words are, every man will be held accountable for their own actions. I give God all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise for blessing me with such a mother, such as you. As well as being an amazing first lady who represents Holy Temple well. I don't have to give y'all these accolades or say all that you do, because God knows all that you do. Yes. And that's the problem now. Everybody want to be praised for what they do and say, and what God, as long as God says, that's all that matters.
Amen.
That's why when my parents sing that song, "May the Works I've Done Speak for Me," I love that song when it comes from y'all. So, with that being said, I cannot dare stand up here and not say nothing about my daddy. He's not as vocal as my mama, but he's that mild, meek, and humble, humble spirit. Even though he's not as loud and vocal as her, but he stands up tall in that pulpit. He stands up tall with wisdom, knowledge, and power. He is also a father, a grandfather, and a husband, a brother, a friend, and a chef. He was also ordained in his mother's womb. So look at that, both of y'all are ordained from God. So, I'm sorry, y'all. So it's this poem I want to read, I'm sorry. The poem says, First Lady. Our First Lady, we love you with our hearts. What do we say? Where do we start? You are so natural at being our First Lady. When it's time to help out, you say yes, never no, or even maybe. You tell us that you are just a phone call away. And when you speak, you practically know what to say. You are the First Lady. Let's take a moment to pray. To say, let's take a moment to pray. No matter if it's morning, night, or midday. You put so much emotion in all the songs that you sing. And you always make time for the little things. First Lady Barbara Bush, Laura Bush, Hillary Clinton, Michelle Obama have nothing on you. Because you demonstrate the character of Jesus in everything you do. So happy to say, Pastor and First Lady, I'm here to say happy 25th passing wife anniversary to my mother and my dad, because you two are love and we'll never vote you away. I love y'all. And as the district choir is coming back to sing second selection, while she was talking, I said that's just so true, because I grew up in the church as well. I'm a PK kid, and just to see and watch First Ladies and how they act, and I said all the time, I didn't have an example of First Lady to watch and to grow, but even before she was my First Lady, I met her at the Bible College, and she's always been First Lady Rachel Jordan, always loving, giving, kind, and it's not hard to give her flowers because she's worth it. I could give her the first, I could give you the word, First Lady, I really would, because she's an example to the younger women of Holy Temple of how to treat your husband, how to treat, you know, people in general, and it's just a privilege and an honor to be here to celebrate such a first grade class, First Lady all the way, amen. So right now, ready for two First Lady, I'm going to pick that piggyback up, this is the call. Well, y'all not moving, choir? The High Dimensions District Choir. As I was talking, y'all was supposed to be making it wait. At this time, the Higher Dimensions District Choir is a slim than themselves. And then we just thank God for our First Lady. She really is, you gotta. If you don't, you may not like her, but you gotta respect her. And that's one thing you're gonna do when it comes to First Lady. And the choir is coming for their deselection. You want to step up your feet, get up out of the way.
Thank you. You have the milk and you bail about it. Everything you like, you put the kids in school, everything up before your family, just like my father used to do. And here they go have the dashes to pack up because you done said something, they chopped their hide, now they ready to go. But it take a real man of God to sit here and stand firm with some faith and say, Lord, you said it, I believe it. And I know that my brother has a lot of faith. I remember one time, you know, I was just 8 years old, only a little boy. And those of y'all know me, y'all know I've been sick since a little boy. I'm a born with asthma. You know, I remember the first time I stopped breathing. Him and my father came in to pray for me. And my brother Mike told me, said, Daddy, can we go to ambulance? My father said, no, son, just keep on praying. So by that time, they ain't looking worse to worse. Mike told me that my eyes walked back. And I started shaking like when you rang one of the chickens, you know, they be dead with the dirt. He said, I'm throwing all this in, he got me scared, and he said, all of a sudden I just stopped breathing. He said, Daddy, can we calm down? But Daddy told me, son, keep on praying. They kept on praying. And Daddy breathed in my mouth, I came back through. No reason, no cold, no asthma, no nothing. Even after my father passed, three more times I was in the hospital and on life support. You know, doctors gave me up. They were telling me there ain't nothing they can do, especially after the last one back in 2011. I recall having a heart attack out in the hand, stopped breathing, and they were trying to revive me. But I had lung problems. Like I said, the part of the lung was shut down, they diminished. And with that being said, the kidney started going out. And I'm telling y'all this for a reason. Because I don't know how long we're going to be here. But I don't know how long I'm going to be here. But I do love my brother. I can sit up here and tell you and talk about him all day long. And never big dude telling you about the good works that he has done. And not just him, I can't say nothing without saying about Sister Rachel. Sister Rachel used to come in the hospital room every morning. She'd be working before she go start her shift. She prayed for me. She come on our lunch break, she praying for me. Before she leave and go home, she praying for me. You know, I thank God for both of them because they're just as beautiful as they want to be. If you go out and eat this, most of y'all that know, they've been out to eat, they gonna pay for it. You ain't got to have no money. They gonna pay for it, they got to tell. You know, I'm like, man, how did y'all do it? You know, I'm like, to me, man, I ain't got no money. I better go back there and watch the fish. I appreciate my brother. I appreciate him, and I know, like I said, sometimes he gets discouraged. But I want you to know, brother. Brother, understand? You know, I wonder all the time. You know, I hope some of your other brothers like me join. Lord, give me strength and the power to do what you're doing. You know, but right now. He's still working on me, huh? He's still working on me. But I want to declare a solo for you, Michael. And I hope it encourages you because I know this is what God has going right now. Praise. You know, I just want you to know if you hold on a little while longer, everything will be all right. If you look out here, see these six nipples sometimes, everything will be all right. God's going to fill the church. I believe he's going to fill every people by the hand home and build a bigger church sooner than we think. So just hold on, pray on, live by long. Everything's going to be all right. Thank you.
praise angels, and then we're going to have a special tribute to Granny and Papa from the grandchildren. Amen. And then we're going to have a solo by Brother Craig Fullerton. I'm going to be out of the way, and we'll be in the hand of the group, Pastor Harry. Amen. So just say amen for God's praise angels.
want to appreciate our granny and papa for everything that they do. Because the things that we ask them to do, you wouldn't even get it. Expect it from every grandparent, but when they actually come through, it's something else. Because I can tell you, we all have special events where it's sometimes, like if our parents couldn't make it, we always can count on them to be in there. And we, anytime we come to them for help or support, whatever we're going through, we can always rely on them to give us good advice and godly advice, not just good advice. And it's always something because, you know, I can say personally that I've been influenced by their righteousness and things like that. So we're going to school. And a lot of people come to me for advice, but I just get advice that I've been told from the people around the house. And I go also when they taught my uncles, my father, and things, and they raised great people to raise great children and things. And we just want to go ahead and give them a tribute today. We're going to keep it short, sweet, simple, and we're going to get out y'all away.
Thank you. Every time